The buzz around agentic AI grows stronger every day. AI models are getting much more intelligent, and the cost of intelligence is plummeting. We are firmly in the AI-first era. For enterprises, the real question is this hype, or is it truly an inflection point for their own business? Welcome to AI Academy. My name is Shobhit Varshney. Agentic AI is absolutely an inflection point for enterprises, but only if you do the right AI and you do AI right. The foundation for autonomous enterprises is being laid today. And those who built with adaptability, governance, and the vision will forever redefine the future of work. So we start by looking at the workflows inside of organizations that need to be radically transformed to deliver higher value. Those are spaces where I can't quite create the decision tree of every step that needs to be done. And those lend themselves really well to agentic workflows. We then look at how people have to get upskilled and change the ways they're doing things, and then eventually the tech, data, and the governance that's needed to enable it. As enterprises go on this journey of agentic AI, there are four levels in which they get automation. The first level is basic automation, robotic process automation. You figure out how work gets done day one in an organization. You map it out on a whiteboard saying that here's how a claim is processed or a credit card application is processed in an organization. Once you have documented it on a whiteboard, what we can document, we can start to automate. Level two is where you take a fixed workflow and then you start infusing AI, generative AI at particular steps. So I start to deliver more automation by pulling in some generative AI models. But fundamentally, it's still a fixed workflow that we are automating. Level three is where you start to unlock some of the unstructured workflows. We're able to delegate small quantum of work to an AI agent to go do that autonomously and bring it back. In doing so, humans, as they're interacting with these agents, start to create a golden record of how work is actually getting done. You now have a golden opportunity to start going up to the level four, where you have a multitude of different agents who are performing together as a team. Once you get to this multi-orchestration, you're unlocking intelligence for the entire enterprise. You're no longer doing siloed tasks. You get to a point where you can start to orchestrate outcomes for the organization. AI agents have the power to drive real results and take organizations beyond the basic automation and broad productivity to solving some of the most complex processes in these organizations. It's all about integrating the agents where they count, ensuring that they have all the context they need with the right guardrails and guidelines so we can responsibly scale them to meet our needs. Organizations can move beyond siloed pilots by building a unified agent orchestration layer that then captures all the hidden workflows, enables cross-functional collaboration, and measures success based on speed, accuracy, and cost. The chief data officer has a very critical role to play here. You need to have a really good discipline, a good data foundation, and the right checks and balances and controls in place so the AI agents can get to the data, can re-engineer the processes, and then unlock the business value. You want to centralize all the assets and governance so you can democratize innovation and federate it. So if there's a particular group that wants to go build a marketing use case, another one wants to use a legal R&D use case, they should be able to tap into a central set of assets where all the orchestration and auditability and the controls are managed. How do you delegate the work down to these agents? How do you orchestrate intelligence across different silos in the context of the user's question? The big challenge is where do you orchestrate intelligence? And your two options right now are vertical agent solutions and horizontal agent solutions. The vertical ones are provided by your specific vendor SaaS solution that provides you HR processes or another one that does your procurement processes and stuff. Inside of these different silos, the AI agent has access to the data inside of that, and they're creating these smaller workflows inside of those SaaS providers. The horizontal AI agentic AI solutions are looking at us across. So they have an opportunity to go across different silos and pull intelligence across each one of those. When AI agents are embedded across systems and are empowered to own the outcome, they become strategic drivers of platform-level transformation that's capable of delivering real results that generate true business value. We believe the horizontal solution gives you more independence and more control over what happens with these AI agents. So you have higher control over the governance of how they were trained, what kind of guardrails are available, are they getting the right accurate answers or not? And then these horizontal solutions are able to tap into agents that could come from all different vendors. Most organizations would require an orchestration agent at the very top that understands the full context of the end user and be able to narrow down which agents are suited for this particular question. The orchestration agent has to have access to all the other agents and be able to delegate work back and forth, be able to create the right context and pass it on, have the right access controls, and be able to verify the output that it gets from each of the smaller agents. The central system is in place to do all the governance and auditability. There are two ways in which we really train these AI models. One is imitation learning, where I'm telling you what steps to follow. For my young daughter, I'll teach her long division. I'll tell her exactly how to do it, give her a few examples, and she's able to extrapolate out to other long division. The second way of looking at AI is doing the reward mechanism around it. My son walks into an arcade. The first time he ever sits in front of this game where we have flying pigs, he's never played this before. After 3-4 times, he makes it to the next level. How's that happening? He's getting some reinforcement on both reward and penalty, and he figures out what the outcome needs to be. So that is called reinforcement learning. I'm reinforcing an outcome and giving you a reward for it. I strongly believe the job of AI is to amplify human intelligence. By treating AI agents as trusted employees, investing in orchestration and embracing reinforcement learning, organizations can unlock scalable intelligence and sustainable innovation. So when you're recruiting an AI agent, you should be very clear on what kind of training this AI agent has had, have full transparency on what data was gone into the training processes, what domains it really knows really well, what has it been fine-tuned on recently. So you have a good definition and transparency around that model. Next, you want to make sure that you are able to teach them how work gets done in the organization. So this is when you start to fine-tune and adapt the AI models into your own domain. 99% of enterprise data is not represented in these LLMs. So we need to go infuse those LLMs, those large language models, with our enterprise specific data, fine tune them and tailor them to our usage. Day one, it may be brilliant with external knowledge. You still have to onboard them into our way of doing things, our enterprise data sets, and then have a constant feedback loop mechanism so they start to evolve and understand how work actually gets done in our organization. Then you start to give them access to backend systems only to the extent that they need to. We have constant monitoring to make sure that they're not doing something that's not with the guidelines. Then you get to constant evaluation. The data exhaust that's coming out of how they're working, you need to have enough instrumentation so you know where they're doing, what kind of workflows, and how do you course correct, how do you know that they're getting the right answers. There's always a human in the loop. If there's something of more importance that has a higher risk threshold, it needs to be sent over to a human so they can make a decision just like my manager does in my organization. As enterprises stand on the edge of the new era, the shift from task automation to outcome ownership marks a defining moment for the evolution of AI. I think that's where it starts to break away from how humans solved it to how AIs will natively come up with more creative outcomes and how to get to the final business outcome that we're looking for.